Okay, one more presentation before lunchtime. I'm going to do my best with the last name, even though you just told me. So our next speaker is Vincent Skrzyna, who was on dialysis for 7 years until his kidney transplant here at ChristianaCare. Polycystic kidney disease can be traced back 4 generations in his family. His maternal grandfather and grandfather's sister had PKD, and his mother was diagnosed with PKD in 1981. Shortly after his mother started dialysis, Vince found out that he carried the gene for PKD as well. He and his wife Carmen have 5 children, and his 3 daughters have all tested positive for the same gene. Vincent?
Thank you very much for inviting me here. I'd like to start off with a few words as soon as I get my reading glasses. Living with PKD. There are 3 care issues in dealing with PKD. First is that a patient must have a positive attitude. Second, caregivers must have a dedicated attitude towards their patients. And third, the doctors must have a responsibility towards their patients. Speaking for myself, I found that with a positive attitude and a strong will to overcome my disease, it helped me to cope with all the adversities that come with PKD. All patients must rely on their caregiver, whether it is their spouse or family or friend, who takes on the responsibilities of seeing that you are taken care of. Each caregiver will have a huge responsibility, and by learning about PKD, can help the patient in more than one way, especially in being able to cope with the disease. It is a huge responsibility for the doctors treating patients with this disease. The patient and the caregiver need to work with the doctors and to understand the treatments that will be necessary to prolong your life until a transplant becomes available. For those of you who don't remember the series on TV in New York City, the name of the series was The Naked City. And at the end of that series, they would say, now this was 1 of 8 million stories in The Naked City. Well, mine is one of many of that disease that I have. Speaking for myself, I can only say what I have experienced. I know a lot of the patients have different experiences than I had. The picture that you see here is when I first started on dialysis about 6 months. I was already putting on a lot of weight. At that time, I was about 220. I got up to about almost 300 pounds. In 1981, my mom was diagnosed with PKD. At that time, a lot of doctors didn't even know what PKD was. My mom went on hemodialysis. She was on dialysis for 24 years. She was afraid to go for a kidney transplant. She was just complacent that she was on dialysis. She went to dialysis 3 times a week, and that was fine with her. But after 10 years of being on dialysis, she started to have a lot of problems with the fistulas that were placed in her arm. Eventually, those fistulas will not be able to be working in her arm. They would have to replace it and put it in another area of her body. When I saw what my mom was going through, I decided to investigate and find out everything I could about polycystic kidney disease. At that time, there was no computers. So I picked up some books, and I read about polycystic kidney disease. At that time, they didn't know that much about it, except that the kidney would form cysts. So I put my mind to saying to myself that if it comes down that I need to go on dialysis, I will find out the best methods for me. So I found out about peritoneal dialysis. And I said to myself that I think that might be a good option. It was less invasive. I didn't have to worry about having a fistula put in my arm. And I didn't have to worry about going to dialysis 3 times a week like my mother done. When I was told that I would have to go on dialysis, my doctor in New York, when I was still living there, said, well, we're going to put you on hemodialysis. I says, no, I don't think so. I'm going to go on peritoneal because I feel that was a better option for me. Well, I didn't stay in New York. I moved out of New York just right after that. I came to Delaware. And at that time, I was starting to feel sick. I moved here in August of 2003, and by January of 2004, and that was on January the 15th of 2004. I remember that because it was my father's birthday. I went in, and I had them insert the tubes in my stomach. I went to the dialysis center at the beginning, and they asked me if I would like to learn how to use the machine, that I wouldn't have to come into that. So I says, fine, let's teach me how to do it, and I'll bring it home, and I'll do it at home. Well, when I took the machine home, I realized that by me staying in the house and doing it, it was going to take a lot of my time. But I was fine with that because I didn't have to go to the clinic 3 times a week and have my blood drained. So every night at 8 o'clock, I get upstairs and go on the machine until about 6 in the morning, when I would get off. And I would do that seven days a week. During the time I was on peritoneal, I realized that I was gaining weight, whether it was from the solutions or from the medications. I had developed different complications with my stomach. I had hernia. I had a blockage of the intestines, which I had to have an operation. I had a massive heart attack. My aorta valve was almost closed. Thank God I was in the hospital at the time, and that they were able to take care of me right away. I was visiting someone, by the way. That prolonged my getting a kidney. That was in October of 2009. So I had to wait an extra year before they would call me for a kidney. Finally, when that time came, they brought me into the hospital, and I had my kidney transplant. That same day when I came off out of the operating room, they had put me on steroids. Well, I felt like Superman. I just got out of the bed, and I felt like this was no problem. This operation, I thought, was really bad. Well, 24 hours later, when you come down from those steroids, it's not a joke. Well, I survived for about 3 weeks until they realized that I had an infection in my kidneys, my polycystic kidneys. So they rushed me back into the hospital. And they took my two kidneys out. They were about 10 pounds each. I stayed in the hospital for weeks. I couldn't eat. In fact, I didn't eat for 5 months. I was on very low liquid diet just to keep me alive. So my wife, who was my caregiver, came into the hospital and said to me, "They can't do anything for you anymore. You need to get out of that bed and do something for yourself." So I did that. I got out of bed and I started moving around. It took 5 months before I started to get a little appetite. By that time, I lost 100 pounds. I looked like I just came out of a concentration camp. People didn't even recognize me. My wife was there pushing me. I thought when I was in the service that I was having problems with my sergeant, but she showed me what it was to really have to take orders. After that, I went for therapy. I started to build myself up. I decided to take up tennis. So I went and I enrolled in an indoor tennis. And I started to do tennis. And I did that up until last year. And I was in pretty good shape. I was able to run around the court. I was in a beginner's class. And I stayed in the beginner's class for 4 years. And the reason I stayed was because the new people who came in didn't know nothing. And I was a better player than them now. So it made me feel good. But I just want to say to those patients who are on dialysis, never give up hope. You need to keep that positive attitude. It's tough. Don't get me wrong. It's tough. I've been through it. I'm still not well. I have episodes of pneumonia, urinary tract infection, bowel problems. But I just get up every day and I go out there. I volunteer with the VA. I transport veterans to the hospital. I work with the PKD Foundation. We do fundraisers. We're having a walk, by the way, tomorrow. I work with the senior center, trying to help out the seniors at the senior center. So I find my therapy is keeping busy and not giving up and not depending on everyone. Depend on yourself. Because if you depend on someone too much, you get too relied on that person. I also want to say one more thing. I like to say there's people who say they have a hero. Well, my hero's sitting here. Joanne Smith. She was my nurse when I first started dialysis. And not only that, she gave up one of her kidneys for her patient so they can live a better life. So I'd like her to stand up and give her applause. I'm sorry I get a little emotional. But I just hope by me speaking to you and those who have the kidney disease that maybe I can be a little inspiration to you. Thank you.